You see, every prophet goes through three stages, the ones we call the false prophets. Mm. The first one is the way of their act, the right. way of the way they do.
Okay.
That is in Numbers chapter 22.
Mm.
Balaam was a prophet.
Mm.
But Balaam was hired by a king, Balak, to come and curse Israel. So they start by what we call the way of the prophet. Then they move into what we call the error of the prophet.
Mm.
You see, when they do something for the first time, it's a way.
Mm.
You can change it.
Mm.
But when you keep doing it for a time, it becomes an error. Then the third phase is the doctrine, the teaching. In Revelation chapter 2, verse 12 to 14, you know, there was a letter written to the seven churches.
Mm.
And it says, the angel of the church of Sardis, mm-hmm. the angel of the church of Pergamos. This particular one is the church of Pergamos. In Revelation 2, verse 12 to 14, he says, they teach others to do the same thing as Balaam did.
Mm.
And that is the doctrine of the people. So if you just come out with a law, I'm afraid that's not the best way to handle it. No law can legislate a man of God or the practices of God. Remember, all power belongs to God.
Mm.
So we are people under authority to God. So our laws should be consistent with God.
Mm.
So if we want to help prophecies or prophets to come out of what they are doing, which we think is not right, let's have a dialogue with them.
Mm.
For them to see eye to eye with us
mm.
and what they can do to come out or to improve upon what they are.
Mm.
I would rather propose that.
Mm. Mm. And